If there's one thing that wastes so much time in my workflow, it's not finding the right tool quickly. This is my new studio, and honestly, it looks super clean. Unfortunately, this is just a facade, because if you take a closer look at my drawers and all the boxes stored around here, it's a huge mess and has been a huge mess for years. Searching the right screwdriver, fastener, or even my 3D printing tools is probably one of the biggest ways I waste time every day. But today, I'm finally tackling this, and we'll not only organize my bench, but also add an organizer system to the wall and get rid of my piles of filament in two ways. Let's discover how 3D printing can be an amazing tool to organize workshop, desks, or anything else you can imagine, and customize it exactly to your needs. Guten Tag, everybody. I'm Stefan, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. I quickly realized that I needed to do a lot of printing for this project, and elegoo reached out at just the right time to sponsor a video featuring their new Centauri Carbon, which comes at an incredibly affordable price. This was a great opportunity to put their new flagship through its paces. Most of the parts I printed for my shop organization system were done on the Centauri Carbon. And you can also bring your ideas to life with elegoo's new flagship. It's incredibly easy to use and works right out of the box without any tinkering. The die-cast aluminum chassis is very stable, allowing you to print parts faster than its competition while maintaining excellent quality. With its enclosure and a hardened steel hotend capable of reaching up to 320 degrees Celsius, it can even print the most challenging materials. This makes it not only a fantastic value 3D printer for beginners, but also a reliable workhorse for enthusiasts. Check it out using the link in the description, and you can see it in action more throughout this video. When I moved into my first studio 3 years ago, I built this movable desk from 3 IKEA Kallax shelves that I screwed together. I added 4 casters on the bottom and a multiplex countertop. Honestly, it has served me very well in my old place and now also in my new studio. Unfortunately, I'm lazy, and despite organizing my drawers by theme, they are chaotic when you open them. It's painfully slow to find the right size tool for the job. This situation doesn't improve when you look at the side, which is filled with Sammler boxes for various items. My 3D printer essentials are just tossed into one, and our CNC kitchen heatset inserts and fasteners are just in another box without any organization. When elegoo reached out to sponsor a video featuring their new Centauri Carbon, I thought I'd finally tackle this, because organizing things with 3D printing is one of the most satisfying and useful things that you can do. And it also lets me put a ton of printing hours on elegoo's first Core XY printer to see how well it really performs. So let's start with my messy drawers. There are many 3D printed organization systems available, but the most popular is probably Zach Friedman's Gridfinity system. Gridfinity is super simple. As the name suggests, it's based on a grid, 42 millimeters to be precise, likely because it's the answer to the ultimate questions of life, the universe, and everything. This grid then fits bins, which can only be as small as one section, to larger ones spanning multiple grid spaces. Not only do you have the horizontal grip, but the system is also designed with 7mm height intervals in mind and features stackable bins, so you can utilize your space more efficiently by placing several on top of each other. Because it's free and open source, it has sparked a vast ecosystem with tens of thousands of pre-model storage solutions for nearly any application you can think of. Part of this ecosystem are even a ton of online generators where you can easily design bins yourself without any CAD knowledge. All of the parts I printed for this video are, by the way, linked in the description, so check them out if you're interested. The first thing I wanted to tackle are my fasteners. My dad always had a wall-mounted organizer in his basement with all the bolts I needed for my childhood projects. My bolt collection in my professional life, however, looks like this, and sometimes even worse. Even when we started selling torque screws in our online shop, I never got around organizing them and always continued digging through a chaotic pile in hopes of finding the right size. So let's solve that with Gridfinity. For storing fasteners, I love these slightly modified bins that have a fillet on the bottom, making it easy to slide out small parts like washers and nuts. To save drawer space, I opted for divided bins for nuts and washers, as well as for the really short screws. Starting at 10mm length, I used full bins, and once the fastener exceeded 30mm, I had to use bins that span two grids. I prepared the print jobs for the bins in elegoo slicer, and then let the printer rip. The Centauri Carbon is incredibly fast, which made printing this large number of bins really quick. To differentiate the various sizes of bowls, I use different colors for each thread size. The individual bins won't be very helpful unless we add labeling indicating which size of fasteners they contain. The specific bin that I use is designed for 3D printed labels, and you could easily add text to the blanks with the label tool in elegoo slicer. Currently, you need to change materials manually on the Centauri Carbon with a pause command, but elegoo confirmed that they're working on a multi-material system for it, and the machine is already fully prepared with a filament cutter and a poop chute. However, since I believe you don't need to print everything just because you have a 3D printer, I simply used my Dymo label maker to create tags for each bin. Then it was finally time to fill them. We sell our screws in bags of 25, which doesn't completely fill most of the containers, but for the moment it's enough for what I need. Though we still lack a base plate. The Kallax drawers aren't the highest quality, as you realized when you noticed that you can't even fully open them. As if that weren't enough, they are also tapered, so standard Gridfinity base plates with spacers won't fit properly. That's why I took the dimensions and simply extended a 6x7 baseboard in CAD to fit the drawer perfectly. The Centauri Carbon has a 256x256mm bed, which is large enough for most prints I usually do, but it's smaller than my base plate. So I cut it into 4 pieces with an on shape and added small connectors so that it's a bit more secure in the drawer. I was able to fit a base plate in 2 prints, and after assembly it fit perfectly in the drawer. This meant it was finally time to add the screw bins. Trust me, this is one of my childhood dreams becoming true, because I finally have a complete assortment of all bowls I usually need for my projects. Color coding really helps me to find the right size easily. They are removable from the base, and if I happen to find a stray bowl somewhere, this handy Gridfinity screw gauge lets me measure it easily and put it back where it belongs. This little gadget is a perfect example of the greatness of Gridfinity. If you have a problem to solve or something to organize, there's a good chance someone already created a Gridfinity compatible solution for it. And this will make organizing my screwdrivers, pliers, and all the 3D printing tools I frequently need quick and simple. Let's begin with my screwdriver collection. As I mentioned earlier, I'm certainly not the first person who wants to organize their Vera collection. So a quick search on printables led me to suitable models. These bins are a type of shadow board often found in tool drawers. They feature the unique negative shape of the tool designated for that space, ensuring that every tool has its own place. This not only makes finding your tools easier, but also allows you to quickly identify if something is missing. The advantage of Gridfinity bins over typical shadow boards is their modularity, enabling you to easily mix and match bins over time until everything fits your workflow. But what are your thoughts? Do you prefer organizing your tools with Gridfinity, shadow boards, or do you also have a drawer of shame? Let me know in the comments. Next, it was finally time for my 3D printing toolset, which presented an opportunity to create some custom Gridfinity bins. I first gathered all of the items I typically need from my box of shame and roughly organized them on a Gridfinity base plate to see if everything fit. There are my nippers, our CNC kitchen nozzle brush, our nozzle pokers, our deboring tool, and tools for nozzle changing, tweezers, grease, oil, and build plate adhesive. For many of those parts, I already found pre-made designs in the usual model repositories. A good tip here is to use Thangs, as they scrape all STL websites and will find you models regardless of whether they are on MakerWorld printables or even good old Thingiverse. I didn't find designs for all of my tools though. For simple parts, especially if you don't know any CAD, you can download filled bins in the right size and use Tinkercad or even your slicer to cut out the negative shapes of the tools that you want to add. Let me show you how this works in elegoo slicer. Simply load the bin, create a negative volume, and scale it to size. You can even add more than one for complex shapes. This works, but honestly, I'm a CAD guy, not cat. So what I tend to do is photograph my parts placed on a cutting mat with its 10mm raster using the telephoto lens of my phone. Next, I downloaded a step file for a container with the right size from gridfinitygenerator.com, which I then loaded into Onshape, my favorite browser-based CAD tool. I cut off the upper part and extruded the base to the height I needed for my design. Then I created a new sketch on the upper surface and loaded the image of the grease and oil. To calibrate its size, there's a trick I discovered. Simply draw a line on the image, which is your reference size, and then add a dimension. This will scale the image accordingly, and you can now drag it into place. Next, I sketched around the parts with a bit of a gap for some play and extruded the sketch to remove the material. Finally, I made a cutout to lift the parts, added some fillets, and exported everything as an STL. For some complex shapes, like my digital multimeter, I even went so far to 3D scan the bag, expand the 3D model in Mesh Mixer to create a slight gap, and then use that as a negative shape within the slicer to carve out the shape. Once all the parts finished printing and the base plates were added to the drawers, it was time to fit everything in there. I used my label maker to mark the drawers in a spot that's not very noticeable from afar, but I can easily find the drawer I need when I stand close to the bench. Honestly, all of this is one of the best upgrades I've made to my studio workflow. Everything now has its place, and I can quickly locate my tools when I need them. When I work with fasteners, I can easily remove the bins and set them on my desk. And since every tool has its spot, it's quick and, even importantly, satisfying to clean my workshop up now. After mastering Gridfinity, let's move on to filament organization. I already have a large shelf in my studio where I store my spools organized by color. However, this shelf only contains PLA because I want to avoid mixing materials and accidentally using the wrong type due to not reading the label properly. This has happened to me too many times, so it's PLA only here. Unfortunately, this led to a pile of ASA, polycarbonate and PETG filament at the bottom of one of my shelves, which was quite annoying and messy. Therefore, I decided to create another filament shelf in the workbench corner for my more technical materials. There are many filament shelf options, but the one I've always used is a variant of the Repcord RepRack. The original shelf uses half-inch electrical conduit, which isn't very common here in Germany. I found an inexpensive yet attractive and somewhat accessible alternative, simple IKEA curtain rods. The holders I designed are perfectly sized to fit two of them on a typical 256x256mm build plate. The RepRack is designed for French cleats, and if you don't have a French cleat wall, it comes with single cleats that also perfectly fit into the cutouts of the hanger for printing. I printed mine in grey elegoo PETG with 4 walls for extra strength, and one of the sets takes less than 5 hours on the Centauri carbon. I melted in some of our M3 heatset inserts and added 8mm screws that will clamp the rods in place so they don't slide out. To level them, I used a line laser level, which has been one of the most helpful tools in the entire new studio build. The single cleats are spaced roughly a meter apart from each other and perfectly fit the 120 to 210 centimeter telescopic curtain rods. The inner, smaller diameter part goes in the back, while the outer pipe sits in the front. Then I tightened the screws and loaded the new rack with the stray rolls that were scattered around the studio. Organization is all about finding things and being able to return them easily, so I added small labels again to indicate where each type of filament belongs. We started with horizontal Gridfinity and transitioned to hanging filament on the wall. So let's explore another vertical organization system that will help me use my wall space more efficiently and also serve as a cool filming backdrop. There are plenty of 3D printed wall organization systems available. In my opinion, the most popular options are Multiboard and the Honeycomb Storage Wall. Both are pegboard style systems with holes for mounting accessories. Multiboard employs a rectangular grid-based system, while the Honeycomb Storage Wall features a hexagonal structure. And since everyone knows that
hexagons are the best of guns,
I had to choose the Honeycomb Storage Wall, or HSW. I hope I made the right decision here. Do you currently use one of these systems? Let me know which one and why you selected it. The baseboards themselves consist of hexagon tiles, which are available in different size options to use the space of the bed of your 3D printer most efficiently. I wanted to create a 7x4 wall, so I had to print 28 base panels, each taking around 2.5 hours on the Centauri carbon. The hex panels aren't simply extruded hexagons, they have a slight undercut. To ensure that the items attached to them securely hold in place, they utilize a snap mechanism. The connector features a small compliant mechanism that's compressed when inserted and then expands again for a secure grip. This also works in reverse, allowing for the placement of the accessories to be non-permanent, as you can remove them with a bit of force. The panels are attached to each other by connectors that are also used to fix the bolts to the wall. I arranged all of the panels on the floor and started the installation. 4X connectors for locations where 4 panels meet, 2X connectors for the sides, and single connectors for the corners. Then I used my self-leveling laser to draw a horizontal line on the wall as a reference to ensure everything is at the right height and level. Marius helped me ensure it was in place, and then I screwed everything directly into the studio wall. Finally, it was time to fill it with all of the accessories I printed. Like with Gridfinity, there's a large community surrounding printable parts for it. You can easily find a ton of options by checking out the remixes of the Honeycomb Storage Wall. If you are looking for something specific or searching in a different model repository, simply add HSW to your search query, which many use for tagging their parts. My initial selection included a towel holder, a glove holder, a holder for my squirt bottle, and many other shelves and tool holders. However, as you print more accessories, you'll also realize one of the downsides of the Honeycomb Storage Wall system. The part that attaches to the wall is quite complex, can protrude from the part, and requires supports. Some accessories only print simple hexagons that slide into the complex compliant part, while others don't print anything at all, requiring you to screw the parts into the adapter. Even though it works, it can be a bit inconsistent and hacky, and I think the multi-board system does a better job in that regard. Nonetheless, my wall was completed for now, but still far from full or finished. And that's the beauty of all of these modular systems. You start with an initial idea of what you want to add, and as you work with it, you realize that some things may be missing or redundant. Over time, you'll add and remove items consistently until it's perfect for your application. Let's finish this video with a less effort wall organization system. I've mentioned it before, sometimes you shouldn't print everything just because you can. The honeycomb panels on my wall amounted to around 3 kilograms of material and 70 hours of printing, even on a really fast machine. If you want to avoid this, you could go with a pre-made packboard system. A very popular option available worldwide is the IKEA Skadis system, which I plan to use below the filament rack for my electronics bench. This way I can finally get rid of those really old storage drawers I inherited from my dad. I've already printed some tiltable drawers, but they're a bit larger than I prefer. So if you have any suggestions for good Skadis drawers and accessories, let me know in the comments and I'll try to fill my packboards with them. And this is also where I stopped for now. I'm sure the four organization systems I've shown you today will continue to evolve over time, now that I finally started working with them. I'm incredibly grateful that elegoo supported me with this project and their Centauri Carbon. Not only was I able to finally dive into Gridfinity and Honeycomb Storage Wall, but this also gave me the chance to put a ton of hours on elegoo's new flagship FDM printer, which is super affordable. It did an excellent job producing great looking parts, and it offers one of the fastest printing speeds of all of the machines here in the studio at the moment. The included double-sided print plate never let me down, and the enclosure even allowed me to print high temperature materials like ABS or ASA just as if it were PLA. There's no tinkering needed after you take it out of the box, and with elegoo slicer, it's a tool anyone can use even if you have never operated a 3D printer before, exactly for projects like this. If you're looking for an affordable, enclosed high-speed 3D printer, I highly recommend checking it out using the link below. So thanks again to elegoo for sponsoring this video, and I hope I inspired some of you to organize your stuff as well. I, for my part, will definitely continue, because there's still a lot here to organize. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you found this video interesting. If you want to support my work, head over to Patreon or become a YouTube member. Also, check out the other videos in my library. I hope to see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye. Not cat. Meow. 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 Meow.